scenario with 51. Everything in Nevada flies.
Go get your man.
And I feel like Nevada fly gonna recap this.
So all y'all wanna know what happened, I'm gonna tell you what happened. He got smoked.
Ain't safe, but they tell you be safe when you out in these streets. Rest in peace, King Nip, stay dangerous, cause motherfuckers play for keys. Keep you a toaster, keep you a toaster. Better keep you a toaster, keep you a toaster.
With all that, you already know what it is, man. Salute to the subscribers, that notification gang. Click and blam, follow me on Instagram, Vada underscore fly. Tell your mama I said hi. Salute to my guy, Showtime SP. The nobody that nobody's the ambassador of the notification gang. I would like to let all of you guys know who watch this content that this is the last event that me and Showtime SP will be recapping, covering separately. I will be moving back to my area, new studio, new look. I'm finally gonna be done with work. Showtime SP and myself will be full time. I appreciate everybody who rode with us. We've been doing this since January. I know people have been asking all the time, where you at? Do y'all live in the same state? Did you kick Showtime SP off? We will be back full time. And when it's full time, I hope you motherfuckers is watching. I really do. I really do. But no, seriously, thank you for the ride during this time. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know how we would accomplish it, how we would get things done. But it happened. And 6 months later, I'm happy to say that we've grown. We've continued to do what we got to do. And it's back to what you used to. You know what I'm saying? But Cortez, yeah, let me holler at you for a second. You got to go find that man.
You hear what the fuck I'm saying, man? Now get the fuck off my stoop, man. Go ahead, man. Go find that man, B. Go find him, B. Unless you like being broke, nigga. My man, go this way, man. Go that way, man. Y'all niggas don't seem to understand me out here, B.
And don't come back until you find that man. You about to lose your privilege of getting any money out here. Ain't you a fucking man, B? Ain't you a man? Yo, the disrespect on your legacy, on what you've done, has hit an all-time high. I seen you, Sue Surf, and Ace Amin face off yesterday, son. It's 5 bands on the line for your battle. If you lose a judged battle for 5 bands to Ace Amin, son, it's gonna be nasty for you in these streets. Like, you almost have to beat him 3-0. I'm not gonna put it out there and make that the narrative. I know how niggas love to do me, but it's funny how your opinion doesn't matter until your opinion matters, right? But anyway, you know, the truth sounds like hate to niggas who hate the truth and all the other slogans that I got. But you almost have to clearly beat him, because the way he was talking to you was silly. Ace Amin is talented. I'm one of the folks that, you know what I'm saying, I wanted to see Ace Amin take battle rap seriously, you know what I'm saying? From the conversations that I've had with Ace Amin and from just knowing who he is as a person, like, he has done a lot for himself, you know, changed his life, you know, ever since he got released from prison, you know what I'm saying? He made a quick shot in battle rap. He got a bigger name quicker than most cats in battle rap. Like, after that top level of battle rappers, the new guys, I'm talking about new generations, like New Jersey Twerks, Geechee Gotti's, whoever else is up there, the Swamps, the cats that's at like the top, the Jada Nightwings, that top layer. Like, when you go to that second layer, second tier, like, there's like a bottom tier. I'm not gonna get into all that shit, you know what I'm saying? I know niggas be wanting to fight, but they don't really want that, but they'll, you know, they're gonna talk crazy. So I'm gonna just go that second layer. Ace Amin has found his way to like that very second layer of the cake very fast, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people say, you know, he got 100,000 interviews and shit like that, but he battled John the Don, and he showed, I said in the battle with John the Don, he needed to show that he could play at this level, you know what I'm saying? It's like somebody gets drafted with a first round draft pick, a lottery pick. Have they really shown that they could ball at this level? So let's take a player like Emeka Okafor, right? He was like the college player of the year, right? He gets drafted very high. Even though he averaged double digits throughout his career, you know, respectfully, 11 and 10, 15 and 5. Like, he had decent numbers. But did he live up to being drafted as the first or second pick in the NBA draft? As a matter of fact, I think it was the Charlotte Bobcats' first draft pick ever. Did he live up to being a franchise player? Did Anthony Bennett live up to it? Absolutely not. And there's a lot of other players. Did Kwame Brown, did they live up to being franchise players? No. Now, when it comes to Ace, I mean, he's just pretty much starting his career. And he's very lyrical. But Cortez, you said it inside of your face-off. You haven't seen a round from him that was scary yet. If you haven't seen a round from him that was scary yet, or you don't feel like he has nothing on you, you can't lose. You cannot lose a judged battle to Ace Amin. It just cannot happen. And if he beats you, it's going to be crazy for you out here. I promise you. Not just me. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just call it like I call it so I can't spoil it. You know what I'm saying? I just do my recaps how I do them. But fam, niggas are going to be... You was on the first URL event when they used to have the little time on the side of the round times at the bottom versus Marv 1. It was on 15 years later. First of all, you shouldn't even be battling. Like, they played you for, like, even... Like, niggas was like Ace Amin was like, yo, you've been on the first event, and you battling me. You know what I'm saying? So he's already got one on you because he's looking at you like, yo, you wouldn't even... Like, Surf was like, you can't even call me for this nigga. Like, are you crazy? Like, I would hang up the phone. I'll curse Beasley out if he called me for you. But we getting past that because I know that you've done this before. You know what I'm saying? Like, you've done the ascensions. Niggas didn't even know how to spell ascension. But you've done a lot of these events. You've done favors. You've battled new guys. That's not the issue. The issue is five bands being on the line and you battling against a dude who you feel like hasn't even done anything. Hasn't done anything. You feel like Ace Amin has... Do I feel like that? No, I feel like he had a great battle versus John the Don. I actually edged Ace Amin in the battle 2-1. It's just my personal preference. I feel like Ace Amin is very lyrical. He has a lot of ability. I felt like that, you know, he needed to be focused, you know, like focus, like battle rap focus. He did that versus Gems. I felt like he had a good performance versus Gems. I feel like he got Gems out of here 2-1. But what y'all niggas don't understand is that Cortez really be beating niggas. Like, he beat the dog shit out of Official. Like, he beat Jack Boy Maine in the tournament. Close battle, but he beat him. Like, if the room... See, Cortez's battle is going to come down to the room. Like, there be battles that he has when the room really fucks with him and his material is real. If his material is landing and he's in a bag, like, when there's money... God, I know why they put money in it. Because if you put money in it, you're gonna get the best Cortez that you're going to get when there's some bread involved. He's from Brooklyn. Look what Brooklyn do. This is just how niggas is. Like, when that guapo's on the line, that guapuccino, fappuccino's on the line, nigga gonna start wilding. But I tell you this, you better not lose to no motherfucker Ace Amin, who's very talented, and think that niggas is just gonna sweep that shit under the rug. I promise you, niggas is gonna be wilding. And it's not just me, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just a small guy with a small channel, but you let that nigga talk to you like that? Nigga, you been in this shit for 10, 15 years. The nigga shouldn't even be able to talk to you like that. This man has so much, like, okay, that's cool. Like that's cool. You done what you did, but you still here with me. Like the niggas that you look up to don't respect you and shit like that. Like, he's talking crazy to you. And that's the only reason why I even made this joint. Because he's talking crazy to you. There's no way that you're going to just let that man come through here and talk like that. Ain't no way. I know Cortez better than that. And I know that he better be in his motherfucking bag today. Because if you let this nigga talk to you like this, and then for $5,000, five bands, and you going to let this shit happen to you like this? Hell no. No. I hope you see this shit. I hope you see this motherfucking blog before that goddamn battle. Because if you let this nigga walk all over you... And the funny thing was, I had picked Ace Amin 2-1 because I just felt like I ain't know if he was going to be motivated. But now, when they put the bread in it, I'm picking it as you better win. Ain't no way. I ain't got no prediction no more. Ain't no motherfucking prediction. You better win. That's what it is. Like, it ain't no... This is a must win. This shit is a must win for Cortez. Ain't no other way to cut it. must-win battle. Ain't no other card or ain't no other battle on the card a must-win. You must win. Ain't nothing else to talk about. Salute to every single one of y'all niggas that watch this shit, whether religiously or in passing. I was just astonished that they was even carrying Cortez's legacy like this. I'm like, yo, this nigga been around doing this shit forever. He got classic joints. He battled Hitman. He battled mad niggas already. And y'all carrying him like he a brand new... Nah, son. All I know is you better... You better come back with that $5,000. You gonna be out here looking for work in Queens, my nigga. You ain't you a grown fucking man, huh? Ain't you gonna let another nigga take your shit? Huh? Nah, you better not. We ain't going out. You ain't going out like that. I know you ain't going out like that. I don't even want to talk no more, my nigga. We gone.
Yeah. The streets ain't safe, but they tell you be safe when you out in these streets. Rest in peace, King Nip, stay dangerous, cause motherfuckers play for keys. Keep you a toaster, keep you a toaster, better keep you a toaster, keep you a toaster. With all that internet beefing, how you out here necking? You mean to tell me you just a loud mouth nigga that's reckless? Some of you niggas got death wishes, you do it for likes. Go viral to get killed later on that night. It's shit crazy to find out you wasn't on that hype. For them views, you really just pay with your life. All the real killers I know, they don't be online. And if they is, they just waiting for you to post your lie. I ride around me and Hamela.